Hello there, despicable students. Today I'm going to have all of you learn about economics. And we are filming in beautiful West Poffenpuppenshire. And we are going to know that we are learning about consumer surplus and producer surplus. And we are going to have a man from the United States of America talk to us about it, since you all definitely hate me. So, from Irvine Valley College, Professor Mark McNeil of economics.
In beautiful West Poffenpuppenshire.
Yes, indeed.
We're talking about consumer surplus, producer surplus, and deadweight loss, also previously known as excess burden. Consumer surplus is defined as the difference between the maximum a consumer will pay for something based on their utility and what they actually pay. Producer surplus, the definition is the difference between the minimum price a seller will accept for a good that they're selling based on their opportunity cost and what they actually receive. There we go. So I'll explain in a second. Deadweight loss, the definition, is lost wealth, that is lost producer or consumer surplus due to some market restriction. And consumer surplus and producer surplus are really illustrations of the wealth that comes from buyers and sellers trading with each other in markets at whatever is they find to be mutually beneficial trading terms. So here's an illustration of consumer surplus. Here's demand. See, this point, every demand curve is a series of points, and this point right there says, at this price, nobody wants to buy it. Everybody's out. But at this price, $50, I don't know what the price was here, $60 here I used. At $60, one person wants it. At 59, somebody else wants it. So now there will be two if the price is 59. At 58, three people will want it. The 60, the 59, the 58, and the 57, there will be four people, etc. And finally, you know, if we could identify them, we could put the names of each of these people, and that point represents the maximum that that person is willing to pay for that good. And this guy right there, do you see that one? That person will only buy it if the price is?
Right.
Zero, right, good. And what about this person? That person will only take it if you pay him to take it. That's a negative price. Anyway, the supply curve is based on opportunity cost. So there's everybody who has opportunity costs greater than $9, we'll say. But at $10. Now, is there somebody who would produce one unit at $11 or $10.50 or something, and somebody else who has opportunity costs of $11, and somebody else $12, and somebody $12.50, etc.? So the supply curve shows what are the opportunity costs of sellers to sell an item, and they won't accept. They won't produce it and sell it if they don't get paid their opportunity costs. They're better off to go and produce or do whatever other thing they can do. Remember, opportunity costs is the value foregone because you come and do this. So whatever you give up over there, that's the opportunity cost. So these are all the points on a supply curve. When you put them together, out of this interaction comes a quantity, equilibrium quantity, and an equilibrium price. So now, when the price in the market is $20, this first person who is willing to pay $60 for it, but only has to pay $20, gets $40 of consumer surplus. This person who's willing to pay $59, that's their maximum, but only pays $20, then they get $39 worth of consumer surplus. This is free wealth because it's worth that much to them, but the market price that they pay for it is only $20. So each person is receiving this much consumer surplus when each of these people buy the good. And finally, this last person right there, what's it worth to them? $20. What do they pay for it? $20. What's their consumer surplus?
$20.
Zero.
Oh.
You got the zero, right? Now, what about these producer guys? This producer is willing to produce it at, we'll say, $10.50, but receives $20 for it. They're getting this much more than their opportunity costs. That is, this person or the seller's producer surplus. This one has opportunity costs of whatever that might be, 11, and they receive 20 for it. That producer gets $9 of producer surplus. This one, $8.50, and as these additional producers' opportunity costs go up, then the subsequent producers, the next new producers, they all receive less and less producer surplus, but they all do get some, except that one right there. The opportunity cost is $20, and they get $20. Now, why will the 51st unit not be traded? Because the opportunity cost to somebody of producing it is $21, and somebody values it only $19 worth. So that trade will not be made voluntarily. Trading stops at that intersection. Now, if we take this area, let's make it yellow here. If we take this area, this first person's opportunity cost is that much, second seller, third seller, all of these yellow lines represent the opportunity cost of producing each of these quantities, 1, 2, 3, etc., up to 50. So this entire area here is opportunity cost when 50 units are produced. This area here, the red stripy area, is the sum total of producer surplus, and this green area is the sum total of consumer surplus. And this sum of consumer surplus plus consumer surplus, it's this amount, represents wealth that producers and consumers receive when they trade with each other in this market. And producer and consumer surplus are maximized. Now, can we calculate these? Yeah, it's pretty straightforward. It would be much more straightforward if I made these straight lines so that we could just take the triangles. So this area is consumer surplus, this area is producer surplus, this area is opportunity cost. Can we find out how much producer surplus, consumer surplus, and opportunity cost there is when 50 units are produced at $20 each? Well, if we know this number, it was 60, I believe, and this number was 10, so it's easy to simply calculate the areas of these triangles. The area of a triangle is 1/2 the base times the height. So, the area of consumer surplus is 1/2, the base is 50 units, and the height is from 20 to 60, that's 40. So I believe 40 times 50 is 2,000 times 1/2 is $1,000 worth of free wealth that comes to consumers because they trade with each other in this market. The producer surplus area is 10 units high, PS, is 1/2 the base, which is 50 again, times 10, which is the height. So that's 500 divided by 2, that's 250 units of producer surplus. Now, the area of opportunity cost you can calculate, but you have to break it down into two areas. You take this rectangle and take that triangle and combine them, and that will give you the area of opportunity cost. Now, what have I done wrong here? There it is, deadweight loss. What if, for some reason, there's a restriction that means that only 40 units gets produced in this market. Well, all of a sudden, the trading stops here at 40 units. Could be a tax, could be a monopoly, could be Guido saying, you can't produce this many in the market. But it doesn't matter. When that happens, we can calculate the new area of consumer surplus. Do you see that it's smaller than before? We can calculate the new area of producer surplus. Do you see that we can calculate that too? And they're both smaller. But right here is the big issue. This little triangle right there. It turns out that that is dead weight loss. Dead weight loss is lost wealth. It's wealth that nobody benefits from. Somebody sacrifices, but nobody gets any benefit from it. And that little triangle of there is the result of some restriction on this market from its optimal wealth maximizing level of 50 to 40. And you can calculate this if you know this number. Say that this is 22 and this is 18. And so if that's the case, then you would take the height, which is 4 units, dead weight loss. You take the area of that triangle. It's 4 units high times 10 units wide from 40 to 50 times 1/2. So that's 40 times 1/2 is $20 worth of deadweight loss here. So deadweight loss is something we're going to see later in much greater detail when we talk about monopolies and other restrictors of markets. Anyway, that's producer surplus, consumer surplus, defined, explained, calculated, and deadweight loss. So what do you say? Accept? Adieu? No, what do you say? Tut tut and cheerio?
Oh wait! My diploma is in chiropractic practices. What am I doing teaching? Lord me. Well, that's good enough for you guys.
This is terrifying. Thank you. Thank you.